Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you LoRaWAN. Before I start with explanation, let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll be discussing about basics of LoRaWAN. Then I'll explain you devices used in LoRaWAN. Here in LoRaWAN, there are three categories of device: class A, class B and class C. I'll explain you all three categories of devices in great details. After devices, I'll explain you basic architecture of LoRaWAN. Then I'll explain you components of LoRaWAN. Then I'll explain you applications of LoRaWAN. And at last, I'll be discussing about advantages of LoRaWAN. So let us start this session with first agenda, that is basics of LoRaWAN. See, LoRaWAN means what? Long range wide area network. Here, communication of device that is having long range. And that network of device that is wide, right? Here one thing that you need to understand first. See, this wide area network that is not developed with the use of cellular network. In my last video, I have explained you NB-IoT, narrowband IoT system. So in that we were been using licensed cellular network, right? While with LoRaWAN, we are not using cellular network. So operating frequency of device, that is unlicensed frequency, right? So LoRaWAN uses unlicensed frequency band for long range communication. So here communication range will be long. Why? The reason is devices will be using narrow bandwidth only. And as if narrow band devices are there, obviously, you can have long range communication, right? So LoRaWAN means long range wide area network, and this wide area network that we are creating with the use of long range of communication, and that is happening because of narrow band operation, right? See, LoRaWAN can be used for range of 3 miles in urban areas. So in urban areas, 3 miles means 4.8 kilometer, right? So in urban area, range is 3 mile and 10 miles of range is there in rural area. And that 10 miles that one can achieve with the use of line of sight communication, right? 10 miles means approximately 16 kilometer, right? So up to 16 kilometer, LoRaWAN devices can communicate. And based on that range, wide area network that can be created, right? If you want to extend the range, then one can use range extender, and range extender for LoRaWAN that is called as LoRaX, right? So here we are using range extender for broadening of that network even, right? See, LoRaWAN devices can have battery life for more than 12 years. Why that humongous battery life is possible with LoRaWAN? The reason is we are having devices operated at low power and low bandwidth. So as if bandwidth of communication is narrow or low, then, but obviously power requirement for that device will decrease. And here with LoRaWAN, you will be observing device battery life that is even more than 12 years. When you talk about devices of LoRaWAN, then there are in general three categories of devices: class A, class B and class C. So first, I'll explain you devices of LoRaWAN. When you talk about class A devices, then those devices will be having longest battery life. Why it is having longest battery life? The reason is majority of times those devices will be staying in sleep mode. As devices are staying in sleep mode, it will be consuming very few power, right? That's why battery life is significant over here. And for class A devices only, battery life can be more than 12 years. See, why it is staying in sleep mode? The reason is it can receive messages only if it have sent the messages. Let me explain you that by some applications. Like you see here, fire alarm or flood detector, that could be the example of class A devices. So here, fire alarm means what? If fire happens, then device will send message. And as if device is sending message, then only device will be receiving message. Otherwise, device will stay in sleep mode. And as if device is staying in sleep mode, it will be having longest battery life. So as if fire happens, then LoRaWAN device will be detecting fire, and based on that, it will forward message on IoT cloud, right? And that device can receive physical response only if it have forwarded the message. Otherwise, it will stay in sleep mode, right? See, class B device that is having average battery life, where these devices are checking network periodically. See, with class A, majority of times devices will be staying in sleep mode. But here, periodically, class B devices will be observing network, right? So here you will be observing. See, it can receive messages even if it has not forwarded the message. So previously, what was happening? You see, it can receive messages means downlink will be activated only if uplink is updated by device. But here, device can receive the message even if device have not forwarded the message. Why? The reason is after some time, device will be checking network periodically, right? For example, metering of temperature and humidity, right? So in metering applications, we can use class B device for LoRaWAN, right? See, third is class C device. In class C device, battery life is lowest. Why? The reason is these devices will be checking network continuously. If device is checking network continuously, but obviously its battery life will go down. So it has minimum latency for messages for uplink and downlink. Why? The reason is it is continuously checking message. So latency for messages will be minimum. So one can use this class C devices of LoRaWAN for real-time applications like traffic monitoring, right? So that is how different devices are there. Now let me show you basic architecture of LoRaWAN. So here varieties of devices, those are end nodes, right? You can observe here we are having pet tracking application. We can have smoke alarm application. We can have water meter. We can have trash container. We can have vending machine. We can have gas monitoring. So likewise, varieties of end nodes are there. These end nodes are communicating to gateways. These end nodes are communicating to gateways. And this communication is wireless communication, right? And that is long range, right? So wireless long range communication that is happening with RF frequency, right? And those frequencies are even different with respect to different regions, right? So I cannot tell you directly like these are the frequencies that we are using. That changes with respect to regions like in India, in Africa, in USA, frequency standards are a bit different. I can tell you like it is there somewhere from 908 megahertz to 928 megahertz, right? But even that changes with respect to region. In short, you can say these devices are communicating with gateway with the use of RF frequency. Once this gateway is receiving data, that data will be given to network server, and that one can give it with the use of Ethernet, right? So here there will be TCP/IP protocol that we will be using it for data transfer. So gateway is using TCP/IP protocol, right? That is there as per secured channel, right? Here, this is connection oriented services that you can say. So securely, whatever data that is received over here at gateway that is getting forwarded over here, and that forwarding of data may happen with the use of Ethernet or 3G. Now this data will come over here at network server. At network server, it will be, there can be so many applications even, right? Where there will be data structuring part. Once that data comes to network server, again that data can be forwarded to application server with the use of TCP/IP protocol, right? So that is how complete architecture is there. Here there are three key components. You see, application server, network server, and gateway. And here end nodes are devices. We have already talked about devices. Now key component of LoRaWAN architecture are gateway, network server, and application server. So let us discuss about key components of LoRaWAN, right? So first I'll be discussing about gateways. See, gateway is operating at physical layer. Why? The reason is gateway is receiving messages from the devices, right? And that reception of message that will happen with RF frequency. So here it is operating at physical layer. One or more gateway receives wireless messages from end nodes with antenna. So with gateway, there will be antenna connected, which will be receiving radio frequency by which message will come, right? So one or more gateway will be receiving messages. It will demodulate it. And once it demodulates the message, it will be message or packet that one can say. Now this packet will be forwarded to network server with the use of internet or LAN. So I have told you, see, gateway is receiving messages from end devices. And that reception will happen wirelessly. It is not happening as per licensed channel. Remember, in NB-IoT, we are receiving that with licensed channel. Here, there will be RF channel that one can say, by which gateway will be receiving message. It will demodulate it and then it will forward it to network server. And that forwarding will happen with the use of internet or LAN. And that is happening as per TCP/IP protocol, right? Second component is network server. See, network server is acting like a router that one can say. So what it does is, it will be handling authentication and authorization of devices as well as messages. So it is performing authorization and authentication part, right? Authorization means whether devices are authorized or not. And it will be authenticating the device as well, right? It schedules the downlink messages. Downlink messages means from the cloud, whatever messages are coming, that has to get forwarded to devices. So those downlink messages means messages to be forwarded to the device. Those are the downlink messages. That scheduling is being done at network layer. And it is also communicating with application server. So third component is application server. See, in application server, there will be application layer, right? And here, see, application server receives message from network server and then it will be decrypting the data as well as it performs encryption of message and it will be forwarding it to network server for downlink. And here network server will be scheduling those messages, right? Application server also handles so many protocols like AWS, MQTT, HTTP, and it is also acting like a broker. And it from application server, we can also observe dashboard, right? So that is how key components are there with LoRaWAN. In future coming videos, I'll be explaining you how these protocols are there in great detail in this video lecture series of Internet of Things. Now I'll explain you applications of LoRaWAN. See, we can use it for street lighting. There are some applications based on smart metering. For location tracking, LoRaWAN is used. For smart parking also it is used. For waste management, there can be use of LoRaWAN. And in agriculture also, wide use of LoRaWAN is there. So there are so many applications. I have listed few only, right? Then when you talk about advantages of LoRaWAN, then it is having high density network. So many devices can be connected with the use of gateway over here. And once gateway is receiving the data, we can upload that on internet, right? So high density network can be created here. See, low power consumption is there with the devices that even we have already discussed. See, high data rate can be achieved up to 250 kilobits per second. That is the data rate which we have it with the communication with the devices. So high data rate doesn't mean like it is there in terms of Mbps or Gbps. It is there up to 250 kbps only, right? See, low cost application is there, like devices will be having cost below $4. That's why this IoT applications are very significant, right? See, low bandwidth application will be there. Here extended coverage will be there. And high mobility is there because of low range communication of devices, right? So that is how LoRaWAN is there with us, and by which one can enable so many applications. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.